Welcome to Martha Hernandez Presents New Mexico Artists. In this series, we present talent from all over New Mexico. Music, art, sculpture, dance, and much more are showcased in each program. Martha has traveled all over the state of New Mexico and brings you lively entertainment and incredible artwork of our New Mexico artists. On this show, Martha visited the 20th Annual National Pastel Painting Exhibition. The exhibition is sponsored by the Pastel Society of New Mexico, a nonprofit arts organization established in 1989 to help promote interest in the soft pastel medium. It now includes members from more than half of the states in the nation. Martha is proud to help support the Pastel Society and wanted to showcase some of the talent of our New Mexico artists, as well as talent around the nation.
Anything anywhere pretty much. Energy line would be the shortest distance between the root system or the root of the stem into the seed pod. So if this stem extended down to here, I'd want to make that mark. Usually that's the first mark that I make. There's some substance to it, and it does keep my hands eventually pretty well. Anything else? Where do you get those holders? pretty old. They went out to this.
No, they cut the Jerry's.
Oh, they cut the Jerry's.
They cut
the Jerry's. Probably Jerry's. Maybe Jerry's does. Something's not right here. It feels like I should be like painting this way. Like Jenny from Kelsey. Is that really I should have gotten my bed of thorns. I use a card paper made by Sennelier. It's been around forever. The guy used the stuff. It's highly textured, expensive, but it's highly textured. You cannot use a wet medium on it. It's made with vegetable flakes, and you can't keep it away from insects too, because they love eating the stuff. And I'm using primarily the two. I use soft pastels. I use medium pastels. Terry Ludwig's, if I can afford them. Rembrandts are a really good in-between medium pastel. You cannot use hard pastels. Use them at your own risk with a high tooth paper like this, a sanded paper. It just won't last. Soft pastels love this. The last thing that I use for color impact are Sennelier, which are also expensive in their French. They still make them the same way. They roll them like a bit of Havana cigar roll. That's what they do with the pigment. They actually roll one for a flesh. They say one at a time, but I don't know. Right? Anyway, I think I'm pretty happy with this. The other thing I encourage people to do is to walk away and before you start rendering, just get the drawing right. And then you can make modifications. The wonderful thing about taping is that you can make modifications. And sometimes, and always squint at your subject. I've even worn a skirt. Or sunglasses at times in the house when I came.
Oh, yes.
Yes, you see, this is your like first thing. Why are you wearing sunglasses?
why don't you learn part of the beaten generation?
All right. I have no secret palette. I have a mixture. Essentially, I encourage people to see light and shadows in terms of geometric shapes. Simplify the shapes as best as you can. Once you've organized the shapes that you like, then you can start messing around with color. And the color is simple. It's recedens, which are cool, and ascending colors, which are warm. So it's real basic, warm and cool. And that's the way my palette is. And it's not some kind of big scientific thing with values, and it's not very well organized either. It's pretty bad. But so what I'm going to do is make a few marks. I'm going to look at some shadows. This is pretty well, isn't it? Nicholas, what am I going to do here?
What's wrong?
It's too low.
Chair.
Too low?
It's a chair, yeah. I have a question about this.
Oh, Oh, sure.
Are oil pastels different from, is there a whole bunch of different kinds of, okay, so what's the difference?
Yes.
Oil, do you know crayons is? The binder in an oil pastel is oil. The binder in this is, there is no liquid in this at all, it's dry. So it's by virtue of pressure, and the binders that are used are not liquid. Oh, and another thing, anybody here is deciding to go buy some sommelier paper, Elkhart paper, by sommelier. You cannot do, you can do an underpainting, but you can't do a wet underpainting. And I'll let Gay explain that.
The whole surface comes off. It's completely, you wind up with blank cardboard.
It's not even long. This is a tricky one because there's really not a lot happening. Usually you have a light source that rigs shapes and defines shapes and stuff. There are only two shadows in this piece. And this shadow is only because the direction is ranging from extreme upper left to bottom right. So being artists, we can cheat, we can do whatever we want. We can create any light source that we want. So I'm going to emulate this light source, and I'm going to assume that this is a partial shadow. I'm using the cool because cool colors recede. I don't mess with backgrounds until I have the one cool color scheme of the subject. Sometimes you work the whole painting, usually I don't. And you can tell by the sound and the feel of it whether one of your pastels is too dry. If it is, you need to pretty much stop what you're doing. If you will remove it to the paper, that's not fun. What I'm about to do.
So, Leslie?
Yes.
Why would you choose, what venue would you go with the oil pastel or the drier pastel?
It's just preference. It's just preference. It's a whole different deal, you know. Oil painters use them to do studies, to do color studies a lot. Pastel sticks are just great because you can just put it down. When you do a study, if you're doing a watercolor or a pastel acrylic painting, it's just a really, really nice, quick medium. It's just fast. And oil pastels, but it takes forever for an oil stick to dry. I mean, has anybody experienced that? I hope that answered your question. But did you get a gift or something with oil pastels?
No, I've had them. And I guess I didn't know the difference between oil, you know, having an oil pastel and this other regular pastel.
Right. It's, you know, it's already mixed. It's just like a pastel in the sense that you don't have a palette. You know, if you want to come up with a bright green, you're not dabbling into your cabbing and yellow and take your palette knife and get your phthalo blue or whatever color you want to make your green with. You're doing it on board. Mm-hmm. And you can do that with the oil sticks. With the oil pastels. This is even kind of nice sitting down. I've never sat before. It's pretty cool.
They seem to be more unforgiving.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Better kind of like figure out what you want in your head before you commit. It's just not an ugly thing.
You can work at the side of the pastel.
Thank you. I work with Ebony. So he's completely combined cool color temperature with warm color temperature. The warm color temperature is butting up against the cool color temperature, literally. This painting was in Taos last year when we had the Millicent Rogers Museum, when we had our signature show. That painting was in the gallery. And he's got the only warm color temperature is a little light to the left of the church.
That's awesome.
And the sunset or sunrise, the only one we had. Sunrise because I think that turquoise blue sky would be that turquoise. So all those purples and violets and indigos and blues are all cool, and it's just going to really, really set everything back. It's just going to set it back ever so slightly, ever so subtly, I should say. So be very mindful of all that. What a wonderful artist. As is Paul Murray. There's a woman by the name of Mary Silverwood who has some pieces in there. But her shadows, she put her shadows in the onion one, we flashed it up, and it was huge. It was like 20 feet high up on the screen when they did it. The cast shadow, she must be, it looked like Walt Disney threw up on the shadow. And there were colors everywhere in this. And it was terrific. Not like her work. I mean, typically not like her.
Changed up the
piece to
the colors have gotten a little
thinner. Yeah. Well, those were more vivid for sure. Those were the older pieces?
I think they were. They didn't look like the older ones.
No. Well, she's not a Joyce Robinson anymore, so. Right.
There's no Joyce Robinson's gallery, but Joyce is.
Those sound things, I tell you.
Oh, no, it's just sound things. So the walkway. This is the ugly page for sure.
Is that paper from the colors?
I'm sorry?
Is that paper from the colors?
Okay, seven different colors.
Here in Albuquerque, New Mexico, and I'm out here at the New Mexico, the 14th annual New Mexico Veterans Art Show with the president of the show here, and he actually, we've got some pieces of his artwork also, and we also have here, what is your name, sir?
Adrian Cisneros.
Adrian Cisneros, and you have something right here yourself?
Third place on a photograph I took at the Vietnam Veterans Memorial in Memorial Day weekend, and I'm there every year.
Awesome. Oh, well, great. Thank you very much. Well, thank you for tuning into my show, and the show goes on up until the 25th. All right, and next year, we'll catch up next year
on
an earlier show. Anyway, thank you for tuning into Martha Hernandez Presents New Mexico Artists. Thanks.
Martha also took a camera to the New Mexico Veterans Art Show held nearby. The purpose of this organization is to recognize, support, and promote the talents and skills of artists who are veterans, serving active duty, are in the reserves, or the National Guard. You've enjoyed Martha Hernandez Presents New Mexico Artists, and thanks for inviting us into your home. Questions or comments can be addressed to Videos by Martha, that's all one word, at gmail.com. Once again, that's Videos by Martha at gmail.com. Watch for us as we will be watching for you in and around our wonderful state of New Mexico. This is Gil Davis speaking for Martha Hernandez Presents New Mexico Artists.